As you can see, the name or title of this video is how to create free weights and how to get free gains. So we're going to jump right into it. For those of you who have not liked to subscribe, feel free to do so now. Your likes and subscriptions will be greatly appreciated. I need as many as I can get trying to get monetized. So I hear a lot of people telling me, or a lot of my people I've talked to lately have been telling me that the reason they don't go to the gym, the reason they don't work out, because they can't afford it. They just simply can't afford a gym membership, or they can't afford to go out and just buy weights. Not everybody has a job. I mean, I get that. And I don't think having a job or not having a job should hinder you from being able to be in physical tip-top condition. I think everybody should be able to at least be in some type of physical shape. And but people saying that is a reason for not getting in shape led me to thinking there's other ways for people to be able to afford weights and to be able to work out for free. So I got to thinking back when I was not doing so well, which I'm still not doing nowhere near where I want to be and not doing well by any means. But I got to thinking back way back in the day, what would I do when I was trying to get in shape when I was younger, before I had a company or had a job? And things I remember doing was push-ups and sit-ups. And push-ups was just as good as exercise as anything to me. So I'd like to explain to you how you can use your own body weight as your main equipment. Like I say, push-ups, get you three good sets of push-ups in the beginning of your workout. I think that's always a good way to get started. Now, three sets to me would be three sets of 40. Three sets to you might be three sets of 20, or maybe three sets of 50. Either way, you do your what you are comfortable with doing, or where it feels like you're almost at your max doing. So you start off with that, then maybe go off to some stomach crunches, get you about three sets of those in. Then use some back laying lunges, is what I call them. Basically, you put your arms on your mattress like so, or a bench, or whatever you have around, a sturdy table, and with your legs kicked all the way out, just go all the way down and back up, all the way down and back up, doing you some lunges that way, using nothing but your body weight. All that stuff is free. Now, when it comes to curls, I got two methods. You can either use water bottles, which everybody should have a water bottle in their house, a milk jug or something. Everybody has something like that just laying around their house, probably about to go to the garbage. Pour that bad boy out of the garbage. Throw you some water in there. If you ain't got running water for some reason, go out to a pond, fill your jugs up with water. Or if you ain't got a pond close by, even better than that, go outside, get stuff it with some rocks. If you want heavier weights than you can get inside of a jug of water, fill it up with rocks. That way you got, you know, heavier stuff to lift. But as I've always talked about in these videos, it's not about how heavy your weight is. It's about how you lift the weight. Technique is everything. However, if you get some jugs of water like this, that don't weigh a whole lot, but it's enough to give you some resistance. Like I was explaining in previous videos, resistance is the key. When you're going down is where you're getting most of your exercise from. So with these jugs of water, you can get just as ripped as somebody that has 20-pound dumbbells laying around. Now, these don't weigh 20 pounds. They weigh more like 6-7 pounds. But nevertheless, you can get just as good as a workout of them. So just like on the other videos I showed you, you snatch up, slow down. Snatch up, slow down. And these little handles are proven. They're not going to break. They're plastic, but I've used this method before. Been people I know has been doing it for years. You ain't got to worry about that. Snatch up, slow down. Snatch up, slow down. Where I'm getting my exercise is going slow down. I'm going to slow down even more because I don't feel like I'm getting enough burn. And now I'm feeling a little bit of a burn. Like I say, do you about, I did 12, I think, lost count. Do it until you feel a good burn, getting you a good pump. It's all about the pump. And if you notice, I'm not going all the way down. Let's keep a bend in my arm. Snatching up, slowing down. Snatch up, slow down. Keeping that bend right there. Slow down. Slow down. Take your little breather. Drink some of your protein shake. I showed you in a previous video how to make an Elam shake. Get that bad boy blended up real good in the blender with all your ingredients in it. Does about a good. No milk in this. Zero milk. All you need from the one I make is strawberries, blueberries, creatine, protein. I drink this, use it before I work out, but today I have a little bit left over, so I'm drinking it during the workout. Normally during the workout, I'll be drinking water. And after the workout, I drink water. I drink water throughout the day. A lot of people drink these after their workout. But to me, I don't know why. I've always just drunk them before the workout, and it just feels right to me. So that's another thing I always say, go with what feels right to you. You know, what's good for my body may not be good for your body. Everybody's different. That's what a lot of fitness instructors won't tell you. They'll have you doing some type of workout and all kinds of stuff that's good for them or their other clients, but they don't look out for your best interest. You got to do it. Your body is going to tell you what's good and what ain't good. You know, your body, just listen to your body. It's the main part of fitness is listening to your body. Your body knows what's good for it. That's good. But while we're on that subject, a lot of people talk to me about their worry about injuries and overtraining and stuff of that nature. Once again, listen to your body. If you go to do a bench press and you feel like an unnormal pain, not a sore pain, but like just an uneasy feeling or uneasy pain right in here or anywhere, you know, if your body's telling you, no, this don't feel right. You know, your body will have certain ways to tell you, like, I want to go bench press today, and everything just felt unusually tight, right? You're like, felt like I was about to pull a muscle if I kept bench pressing. So, honestly, I quit bench pressing. That was actually last week. I quit bench pressing and went back to doing push-ups, which is free because you don't have to buy a bench, you have to buy weights. So, I went back to doing push-ups, and honestly, I can tell my shoulders look a little wider, and I just feel looser. I feel better. I'm not as uptight as I was when I was doing the bench press. Altogether, honestly, I prefer push-ups over a bench press now. It's just straight up. Now, if I was a weightlifting guy that was going for competitions and stuff, maybe I would be more inclined to do bench press. But just for somebody that's trying to get in great physical shape and, you know, be physically fit, push-ups is plenty. Don't ever let nobody tell you something wrong with push-ups. If they ain't getting no results from push-ups, they're not doing enough. They're not doing enough sets. So you can't just do one set of anything. You got to do that extra set to lock it in. Three sets is what I say to do of any exercise you do. Whether it be push-ups, sit-ups, jumping jacks, whatever. If you ain't doing three sets, you ain't locking it in. You got to get it locked in to get those results. Oh my goodness, that was good. Folks, if you want to see how that's made, I've got a video on this page. Just, you can scroll down the playlist and it tells you exactly, just I think it's how to make an Elam shake or something like that. Freaking delicious. All right, to reiterate, snatch up, slow down, snatch up, slow down, snatch up, real slow. If you're not feeling the burn, the slower the better. And it don't hurt. Then on my third set, it don't hurt to sit there and get you some pumps in. the whole time you are pumping, you need to keep your arms flexed as much as you can. Keep a flex going and squeeze your hands tight on whatever you're holding, whether it be a dumbbell or these jugs of water. Keep a tight grip. The more you stay flexed while you're working out, the better. The better results you'll get. So that's how you get free weights. These are free weights. Cost me nothing. They're laying around the house. I put water in them. Got zero money invested. I can do all kinds of exercises with them. Just an example. Highly recommend it. It feels good too. Good weight. Full jug of water feels good. Like I say, if the water's not enough weight for you, fill it full of rocks. You know, I mean, it's free. There's no excuse anymore. You got free weights. But to demonstrate with a dumbbell, a perfect curl, I'm not going over this on any video, but it just frustrates me. And a few times I do go to the gym, I see somebody over there just slinging the weight or just. They just throwing the weight around. They're doing it all wrong. A lot of people do curls completely wrong. And one thing I'd never go over in the video is your grip. So I have to go over that now. Regular dumbbell. All right. You need to have your arm. You'll need to have it like this while you're curling. You can. That's a different curl, though. It's a different curl. But if you want to get the best result, to have a wider bicep up front, you want to turn it like that while you're curling, then snatch up. Slow down. Snatch up, slow down. Snatch up, slow down. All right, so that's one curl. You got the hammer curl. You're gonna have it like that. You're gonna snatch up, slow down. Snatch up, slow down. The hammer curls are some of my favorite too, by the way. Your form is everything. Without perfect form, you got nothing. I mean, you can get results with, I shouldn't say you wouldn't have nothing. If you're sitting, if you're doing like this, you're going to get something. You just ain't going to be near as good as it would be if you had perfect technique. Snatching up, slow down. Snatch up, slow down. So, that's how you do the proper curl. With the regular dumbbell, like I've went over before, there's no excuse anymore. You got free weights now. Like I say, I didn't go over one more thing. I'm gonna go over about the weights of workout. On the start of a workout, like I said, start off with three sets of push-ups. Get your three sets of crunches in. Then I do three sets of curls, and then lunges. If you like doing lunges, get your three sets of those in. That sounds like a lot, but honestly, all that can be done in like 35, 40 minutes tops. Because you're only taking 2 minute breaks between each set. Or not 2 minutes, honestly. Probably 1 minute between each set, 2 minutes between each exercise. So all your breaks combined, it'd be like 10 minutes. And after that, you're basically just running through rotation. At the end of the workout, though, this one may push it into 40 minutes. You need to go ahead and get you three more sets of push-ups. And you don't have to do, if your max is 20, you don't have to go 20 the whole time. Just as many as you can without getting completely exhausted. Save just one or two in a tank now. Now, I never want you to get completely, work yourself to a complete exhaustion. But go ahead and get some push-ups in. Get you one set, two set, three set. And then you'll finish your workout up. So, again, three sets of push-ups. Three sets of sit-ups or stomach crunches. Then the three sets of curls. Three sets of lunges. Then follow it up with three more sets of push-ups. And that workout, man, you'll be feeling great and you'll be looking good. You can actually do that workout once every 2 days. When you first start working out, for the first week, I recommend doing about 5 or 6 days out of the week. Probably 5 days. I did six, but 5 days out of seven out of the first week. Go ahead and get yourself used to it. You're going to wake up sore the next day, of course, but just work the soreness out. Don't be afraid of soreness. Just work through it. It's not going to kill you. I promise you. But one key thing you got to do before you do any of that is stretch. Don't forget to stretch whatever you do. It's probably the most important part of a workout is stretching. You need to get like against a wall like this or something. Stretch your arm out like that. Each one of those. But I always do that before working out. All right, now lower body. If you do not have stairs in your home, like I do, you can go find the nearest high school at the football field and go up and down the bleachers. Walking up and down the bleachers with some dumbbells, maybe 5 or 6 pound dumbbells, or some water jugs, up and down the bleachers. Here at the house, I use these. I go up and down the steps while I'm curling. I'm not really worried about technique while I'm doing that. That's why you see me going all the way down, or down further than I normally do on my curls. But it's all about just getting that pump. I'm really there to work my legs out. But I'm gonna go ahead and get my arms pumped while I'm going, just to keep my heart rate up. The more blood you got flowing through your muscles, the better everything's gonna be. You need blood just pumping constantly. Now you don't want to work. Now if you're trying to bulk up, you don't want to be doing that too much. You don't want to run a whole lot. When I actually do stairs, I get in a hurry, but I'm like, get on my toes and run up. I step, like I was just showing you. I just step quickly and keep my arms pumping. That's part of my lower. Honestly, on lower body, I don't go too extreme. I'm not a real big component of deadlift at all. I think it's bad for your, I don't believe in maxing out a lot. And deadlift tends to lead to that. To me, deadlift is just better than your joints altogether. I do squat though. I do like squatting, but I'm not going to say you need to. When it comes to legs, the main thing I think is important is to run steps or bleachers with the weights in your arms or you pump them. That will get you more cardiovascular shape than anything, and will just make your legs a lot stronger. And the main thing it does is build your core. If you're doing it the correct way, you'll feel it right here in your abs. But when it comes to squatting, like I've said in previous videos, if you start one of my workouts, the only thing you're going to have to buy is a curling bar and the weights to go on the curling bar. So, and the curling bar looks like this. This is the curling bar I'm talking about. It's the one with the bends in the middle. So you can do all kinds of different curls with it. You can do top curls like this. Go underneath. The curls like that. Or you can go out, flat grip. But another purpose for the curling bar is, instead of going out and buying a straight bar to do curls with, throw that bad boy back here, and just do your squats with this bar. It's also good for this, my favorite workout. So, like I said before, if you're going to do my workout, that's really the only thing you got to buy is that curling bar and some weights. But you really don't have to have that to work out in general. If you're just going to do a workout, you can do the one I just described to you, and you will get great results without having to buy a curling bar. You can just make your own weights. These things right here, I went over. You can use your jug of water. Instead of squatting with that, you can squat down with these. Going up and down like that. It's not going to add much weight to your squat, but it's better than nothing. So if you don't have any money, keep balling on the budget, have no shame in your game, these right here can save the day. These jugs of water are free. Free weights that you got laying around your house right now. So don't be afraid to use what you got to take advantage of it. You know what I'm saying? Use what you got and make the best of it. Don't let nobody tell you there's nothing wrong with working out with jugs of water. It's better than doing nothing.